So we're going to talk about a couple of the U.S. laws related to cybercrime and illegal online activities. The first one is the U.S. Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, CFAA. Actually goes back a while. But the goal of this law or this act was to define what is criminal when it comes to things that you do online. So various types of online abuse, and then define criminal sanctions against those kind of actions or activities that constitute abuse or fraud. So it really covers unauthorized access to computers. So you're not allowed to be someplace. In the physical world, we have laws like that. Here we sort of trespassing somebody's computer that is connected to the internet, and we can reach out to it. So a computer obviously has things of value that you are after if you happen to be the cyber criminal. That's who is being targeted by this law. So I said it goes back a while. So initially it was rather narrower. It was trying to protect it. Sort of motivation came from national security, national defense. So it's saying if you gain unauthorized access to a computer that has data related to national defense, that is illegal. This was then extended to financial data because people do care about their money, and criminals, cyber criminals actually after money. They want to steal your online account or steal credit card information and so on. If you access either defense-related or financial data and then access it unauthorized, CFAA says that that's an illegal act. So what exactly is unauthorized access? Unauthorized access essentially is getting hold of this data, getting access to it. So that's, remember when it came to data, we had the confidentiality, integrity, and availability requirements that we had, the CIA requirements that we had defined when you talk about securing data. So getting access to it, you're able to see the data that you shouldn't be able to see. Use it, for example, for financial gain. Modification is affecting its integrity, corrupting it, destroying it is exactly that. Disclosure is to anybody who's not authorized to see it and so on. If all this is done when the system under consideration happens to be a government system, well, that's how CFAA started. So this basically saying the law sort of covers access to information, its modification when not allowed to do so, and using that information in any shape and form, destroying it, affecting availability, that's what you would do with this, is illegal. So this one initially was something that is operated by or on behalf, so it could be a contractor, the U.S. government. But this, I said this has a history, this was broadened to include any computer. They said actually the language, any protected computer. This basically a protected computer is any computer that's connected to the internet. So protected computer, if you access it without permission and gain access to the data or destroy it or corrupt it while you're committing an illegal act. It then actually keeps getting more and more specific. So transmitting code or malware, malicious software that can damage a computer, well, that's illegal as well. And finally, it specifically addresses passwords that are used to gain access to computers. So if you steal a truckload of passwords and want to sell them in the black market, the underground market, that's trafficking in computer passwords. And if you did that, that would be illegal as well. So accessing data that's not yours in various forms, you know, infecting computers with the malicious software, trafficking in passwords that allow others to gain access to computers that are protected, all those things are covered under the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act that we have in the United States.